Ninebot Max G3 European version, and look how fast it can go. Zero start and 45 kilometers per hour. Without instilling, you can do it now. Check out the video, enjoy, like, subscribe. And today a new bot got released where we have G3 and so on, the new scooters. So it should also work for other scooters. I will write it down here. Plus, the Scooterhacking utility also, there is now a beta version now. Links are in the description. And with the beta version, they also improved a lot of stuff. So guys, you will probably ask yourself now, why do I have this app two times? I have the Scooterhacking utility, and then I have another Scooterhacking utility. And this new version, it's the beta. And when I connect to it, I have to of course press some button on the scooter, the headlight button to connect to it. And here on the top, we can press the three dots and then check out the hardware details. And then we can press here, show UIDs or copy UIDs. And then these are the UIDs we'll need for the bot. And as you can see here, my Bluetooth is 035, VCU is 148 and MCU is 139. BMS is 4139. This is like stock things. And the region is from Europe. And it's the serial number. And if you want, you can donate. I will recommend you to donate. I already donated to the Scooterhacking utility team. I will put a link in the description where you can become a channel member. Or also donate to the Scooterhacking utility team, to appreciate it, because they're really making a cool job here. Okay, let's go to unbind scooter. I unbound the scooter. This is needed, and I will quickly stop the app and also stop the Segway app. They're going to force stop and restart now the scooter utility app. Let's quickly turn off the scooter, turn it back on, and now we can also check again the new BLE, VCU, MCU, BMS version. So everything is updated now. And of course I already done it. I go up here to three dots, then hardware details, and then I copied the UIDs. And now we can go to the bot. So I will quickly go to the bot. Okay, I'm now in the bot inside. Normally, after you get a grant access, as you can see, I granted access to my friend from eScoot Talks. And normally, after you have access, you can type in like start. I will do it one more time. Press enter. And then you have to press I understand. Then you can select the bot, the scooter you have. So this should also work for now for G3, F3, GT3, ZT3. So I will select now the G3. And now I have already copied this stuff, the MCU, VCU and the model. So I can just probably now press here and paste it inside. And press enter. And now I have to wait. I guess in a few seconds, yeah, here already we have the files. So now for the files, sometimes I have to download them two times. So I will now press here and save to downloads. And I will press one more time, save to downloads. And also do it on this one two times, because sometimes, I don't know, it doesn't work. And now we should be able to find them. Okay, now we can go to flash, and then we can select here load from file. This is this one here down. And we have to find the file. So I will quickly search the files needed. So we'll probably have to load from files two times and install this stuff. So let's find the first file to install. So as you can see, I now selected the MCU. And then we can check here is the G3 MCU, and then we can press start flash and see what is going to happen. Nice, on the scooter I can see the screen again. And now I can press here done. Nice. So now let's select the other file. Again, load from file. Okay, I now selected the VCU here that I downloaded from the bot. Now we can press again start flash. Yeah, VCU is a bit faster. Done, I guess. Yeah, I reopened the app now and also turned off and on the scooter. Let me quickly connect it again and see if something changed. So everything looks okay here. Let's go now to tools and try to change the region. So this should now work. Do not change to a 20 kilometers per version. Okay, okay, I understand. And US standard or custom, I can like select US standard now. Now the scooter is beeping. Okay. Yep, it's back on again. Let's connect again. And now we can see down here it stays US. Now let's go to tools. So sadly we do not have SH firmware at the moment, but still we can, for example, on this now go to 32, and if you want to go higher than 32 kilometers per hour, we have to unlock the speed limit. I'll turn it off. I'm in a... Yep. I thought maybe I'm in walk mode, but I don't. Everything works. Turn it off again. So let's quickly check. I set it up, as I said already, to zero start, although I wouldn't recommend it. So let's see. Kilometers per hour, guys. Very nice. So what I did now, I switched back to the European version and connected the European version also to the Segway app. So I have now the European version and the US version connected to the Segway app. And currently I'm in the US version. You can see it by the serial number. So the European version has a GA here. And the US version has GC. So let me quickly check now when I connect to the Segway app. So we are now connected again. And we cannot adjust anything because the Segway app asks us to update to a newer firmware. And I think that we cannot update it now from the Segway app. But we can adjust anything that we need in the scooter hacking utility anyway. And I saw now, I updated previously all the firmwares to the latest firmware. Also the vehicle controller firmware I updated to 1.5.8. But after using the bot and everything, it went down to 1.5.5. So now the Segway app wants us to update again. But if we update again, then the flash protection is on again, and that's what I do not want. So with this firmware now I can switch between US version and German version or European version without problems, and I will keep it like this. And if a SH firmware comes out, I can install it without problems. Maybe do not go to 45 kilometers per hour, maybe set it to 35. It's also more than enough and still dangerous, I guess, if you fall down. Yeah, thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, share, and become a channel member. Bye-bye.